The year was really interesting. A lot of fight between a lot of very good drivers, and the final winner was Jan Kopecky, and who is really a nice guy. The others also, but he is a winner, and we are very happy for him, and we hope he will be a very well-known driver all over the world. It was 12 events in the year. Okay, there is a crisis in Europe, which is quite difficult. But in a way, more or less, we had at the start of each rally between 50 and 80 cars at the start. A lot of young drivers coming. But concerning promotion, thanks to Eurosport, we were able to deliver beautiful images all over Europe. Now we are thinking for the new format for next year, for 2014. We will have another time 12 rallies. The timing will be much better than this year, because we will have one rally each month or each 3 weeks, which will be more easy for all the teams. We will have a new FIA regulation on a point of view technical regulation for the cars, and a lot of new cars are coming. Example, there is a new Ford, the name is Fiesta R5. There will be a new Peugeot, which name is 208 R5. We are waiting also new Citroën R5 DS3 in the middle of the year. At the end of the year, we are waiting for the new Skoda. That means all manufacturers are presenting the new car in 2014 with this new regulation, and it will be, I am sure it will be a lot of success. Then we have decided to introduce a new championship for junior, which has a lot of interest. We have a lot of demands on internet or in our phone call. Junior, that means under 25 years, 7 rallies, gravel, asphalt and snow. And for example, the first rally for this junior championship will be here in Latvia. The drivers must have less than 25 years on next 1st January. And all the cars will be more or less the same, category R2, which is not so big as S2000 or new R5, but it's very good level for young coming drivers. And the winner at the end of the year will be official driver for 2 races in 2015 on a factory car R5. So Latvia will be the first event with this category. Surprises, yes and no. Yes, because some drivers had the spark. You know what I mean, spark is... Okay, Jan Kopecky is a winner, sure. But Craig Breen, who was second, he was fantastic. Another driver who was known before, because Monte Carlo winner and Corsica winner, is Brian Bouffier. He was known, but this year I think he had the spark and he is completely mature. Young driver, French, Stéphane Lefebvre, driving R2 car for the first time here in Latvia last year. The Polish Kajetan Kajetanovic, extra fantastic. So this was good for us, because which is good also is to see that in the past our drivers, young or not young, doing ERC or IRC, which was before ERC. For example, Thierry Neuville is coming from us, now is official factory driver for WRC with Hyundai. Same for Juha Anninen. And this is our pleasure. No, it is not completely different. The ERC could be the step before WRC. Why? It's very easy to come in ERC. There is no obligation to be entry all the year. The cars are 50% maybe more less expensive. The rallies are not so long, and it is really a fantastic school. And what I said before is we show that it's very interesting to begin by ERC and then go further. Why not? Really, we expect number one to have snow and ice, so you have to do your best because last year it was fantastic, but just for the rally it was warm, incredible. But I went on the rally last 2 days, and the roads are so beautiful. Really, it is the best special stages we can imagine in the world on gravel. And on gravel, but we don't want gravel, we want ice and snow. So please do your best. Same as last year, each day we'll have 26 minutes, and the Tuesday after the rally we will have 56 minutes, so including all the report on all the rally. So we will have 4 cameras on ground, 10-12 inboard cameras, 1 helicopter, and more or less 10 people around the table to build the movie. Number one, it's not to polish your shoes, but really, Latvia, Raymond Strux and his team is more or less our model. Really. And we would be so happy if most of the event promoters can see how they must work coming here. It will be fantastic. This is really our wish. European Rally Championship, well, we want to develop, we want to have more official teams by manufacturers themselves, and also a lot of private teams, but high level. We think it's a good average to practice motorsport, because not too expensive. More or less, all the rallies are 250 kilometers, more or less. 2 days rally, cars not very expensive. It's a very good compromise, and I think, thanks to TV coverage, it will be in the future one of the best success in motorsport. We have few contacts with National Federation. We work with a national event promoter who himself is in relation with his own federation. It's very important. What we wish is we must not have only drivers doing European Championship. Rally, I am quite old in this business, and I know exactly what a rally is. If you take a base of 100, it's 10 official drivers, 10 to 20 good teams, more or less professional teams, and then it's 70 to 80% of private drivers. And without these private drivers, you cannot do rally. So our interest is to have a lot of people coming to rallies, which it will be so good for everybody. frankly speaking, motorsport is not only Baltics. You understand? Maybe I can agree that a lot of best drivers are coming from this area. Finnish, Swedish, Estonian, I hope in the future Latvian, we don't know yet. But why not? But Europe is Europe, and we have a lot of very good drivers and very good event promoters also in south of Europe, in France. I think number one in Portugal in Azor Rally, which is a very well organized rally. We will have Acropolis Rally in our championship. So not only Baltics. Our goal is to cover all Europe.